Here we're asked to solve a linear inequality. Now the steps are pretty much the same as algebra, except for one. Whenever you divide or multiply by a negative number, you have to reverse the inequality. I don't think we'll have to do that on this one, so let's just go ahead and use the rules of algebra here. I'm going to take care of the 3 by subtracting 3 on both sides of the inequality there. I get 8x is greater than 16. Okay, and then here I have 8 times x, so we're gonna divide both sides now by 8, and that'll get you x by itself. X is greater than 2. Unlike equations, here we actually get infinitely many answers. Okay, any number greater than 2 should solve the original equation or the original inequality. Okay, so this says 5 works, right? 8 times 5 is 40. 40 plus 3 is 43, which is greater than 19. Okay, 10 works, 20 works, so on. So when you have infinitely many answers, there's a couple ways to present your answers. The first method I'm going to show you is graphing all your solutions. So what I'm going to do here is make a number line. Okay, so it says all the numbers greater than 2. So let's choose a good scale here. Let's say we have 0. I'll go by 2s, 4, 6, 8, 10. All right, so what we can do is shade in all the numbers that work. So here, since this is a strict inequality, strictly greater than, I'm going to use an open dot. And I'm going to shade in all the numbers greater than 2. Okay, so that's all my answers indicated graphically. Now there's another way to present your answers called interval notation. Okay, now interval notation requires sort of parentheses or brackets. So since we had a strict inequality, an open dot, I'm going to use a parentheses to indicate the 2 is non-inclusive. So all the numbers from 2 out to infinity is the equivalent interval notation for this graph. If that was a closed dot, we had an equal sign here, we would certainly use a square bracket to indicate inclusiveness. Okay, but we don't have the equality, so we'll use a round bracket.